Does anybody know what crowdfunding is? Right? We all know. We have different kinds of crowdfunding, right? We have the kind where somebody is looking for some medical expenses to get relief because they've had some large medical expenses and they need a little bit of help with that. We've got people asking for investments into their businesses, or maybe pre-order the product that they need because they want to build that information up, or that capital up, so they can produce the inventory that they need to sell. So we'll look at a few examples on those too. So here we've got Mother Molly. She has a handicapped son, uses a motorized wheelchair. They need a transportation van to be able to transport the son in the wheelchair. She decides to set up a GoFundMe account. A TV station picks up that story and it just goes viral everywhere. Raises $35,000. What does Molly have to do to report that income? Is it income? Is it gifts? So to her, the recipient, it's gonna be gifts, right? But what about the giver? Is it a charitable deduction for the giver? I have noticed a lot of clients this year writing down, yeah, I gave to, you know, breast cancer, MS walk, GoFundMe, not deductible. So lots of times we get clients that just say, here's an amount. Well, we need to maybe ask because a lot of people are donating to those GoFundMes. But for her, it's just charitable. It's just gifts. People gave her gifts, so there's nothing reportable. But what might happen that may require her to do something on her tax return for those gifts that came in? Well, that would be okay, right? Because you just got more gifts than what you originally set it up for. But what? 1099K. Usually the GoFundMe. His question was, who issues that? Usually the GoFundMe will issue that 1099K. You'll see it in a lot of different situations, but it has to be greater than $20,000 and 200 transactions, usually what happens. So depending on what gets raised, will possibly 1099. Why is it a 1099K? Because all those transactions are going through a credit card, right? So it's a merchant services type transaction, so that's why it's a 1099K.